Welcome back to RCN Sports Talk. We're now pleased to be joined by a very special guest joining us on the phone line, the head coach of the George Washington men's basketball program, Mr. Mike Lonergan. Coach Lonergan, thanks for joining us and welcome to Sports Talk this evening.
Thanks a lot for having me on. Appreciate it.
It's our pleasure. Before we talk about all your success this year, I'd just like to get your thoughts on the success you've had overall at George Washington, in particular the last 2 years, back-to-back 20-plus win seasons. What have the last few years been like for you, your staff, the players, and the entire basketball community at George Washington?
Well, it's been really rewarding when we got to George Washington. You know, the program, it's got great tradition and history, but it was definitely down, and the culture of the program needed to be changed, and you know, that was probably more difficult than I ever imagined it would be. So the first year and a half was really the toughest year and a half of my life professionally and personally, just because you know, we had to just kind of change things, and some kids fought that change, but we graduated every player we inherited, and we did a good job recruiting, and you know, and now we're starting to see the results of our hard work. So I'm very excited where the program is right now. We still got a ways to go to reach the goals that we have.
You started off this year on a great note, a big win over Virginia very early in the season. Virginia ranked sixth in the country at that time. How big was that win, and can a win that early in the season, can that kind of set the tone for bigger and better things during the course of the year?
Definitely. It was a huge win for us. We had It was a sold-out crowd, the best atmosphere that I've seen at the Smith Center, and we had to take advantage of that. We knew we could beat Virginia, even though they're a well-coached, great team, because last year we were up by four at Virginia and had a very poor second half, but a lot of that credit goes to them. They're so good defensively. So we played four road games last year against Penn State, Seton Hall, Virginia, and Rutgers, and we went 1-3. And one of our goals this year, we wanted to go 4-0. You know, obviously the Virginia game was going to be the toughest, so getting that win under our belt, you know, allowed us to have the confidence to beat those other teams, and we did go 4-0 against those teams, and you know, it's gotten us off to a great start.
Yeah, I was going to ask you your thoughts overall in the first month of the season. You mentioned Tennessee and Seton Hall and Rutgers among your victories so far. Also, a close ball game against Cincinnati that was ranked 24th in the country at the time, I believe you played them. Your thoughts overall in the first month of the season, and things that have gone well, and things you'd like to still work on going forward.
Well, it's been good. You know, we've stayed healthy, which is a big concern of mine. We don't have any depth inside. That's probably our Achilles heel this year. So we're trying to develop our bench. We have the biggest and most experienced starting lineup I've ever coached. But then we get really small off the bench. We have you know, three or four really quality guards coming in. They've done a great job for us. We got a young man, Anthony Swan. We're trying to develop to steal some minutes in the post for us, and he's coming along. We lost a player, Matt Simoneau, to a season-ending injury, and he was going to be our first big guy off the bench, so that really has hurt us. But what I like about our team is we're getting better. We didn't shoot three-pointers well through the first four or five games, and now we're improving in that area, which I knew we would, and we're becoming a better defensive team. Our 1-3-1 is, you know, getting better now that some of the guys have played it for a few games, so that's what we got to do. We didn't do that last year. We didn't get better as a team, and that was very disappointing this year. We're going to try to get better every day.
Coach, you mentioned the injury, but the top six right now, you have pretty balanced scoring. All five starters averaging over 9 points per game. You've had four different leading scorers so far through the first month. Could you talk a little bit about the offense? And it seems like you have players that can score different ways, including, as you said, the three-point shooting has been improved this year.
Definitely. You know, we're really sharing the ball. We're very unselfish. And now that we're a better shooting team than we've had in the past at GW, we're getting our assists up. So the guys are really taking pride and making the extra pass, and that's made us a really good team. We have a very good passing post player in Kevin Larson. When he's double-teamed, he does a great job kicking it out and finding the open man. So I think our guys really, you know, they all are about winning, and then I think they appreciate more than just how many points they average. I think they really feel good about making that extra pass, and that's been a key to our success.
Our special guest joining us on the phone line this segment, Mike Lonergan, the head coach at George Washington men's basketball program. You mentioned being on the road last year against a lot of your non-conference teams like Seton Hall and Penn State. This year, of course, the flip side is you had eight of your first 11 games at the Smith Center. Does that work for you, having all those games in the friendly confines of the Smith Center? I know sometimes coaches prefer to have a lot of road games early on, but what are your thoughts on having so many home games the first month of the year?
Well, I wish it was a little bit more even, but, you know, when we try to get some high major conference teams on our schedule, they always want to play at their place first, so we really have no choice. So I wish it was more balanced, but it's not. But I like playing at home because we got our confidence there. I think we're maybe 34-35-3 over the last 3 years at home. So our guys really feel good about, you know, playing at home. We've got, you know, I think we'll be a better road team this year than we have been in the past. But we got a beautiful arena, not too big, and our students, they call themselves the Colonial Army. They do a great job of making it hard for opponents to come in and beat us.
You mentioned the A-10 and the schedule as well. You have Fordham, St. Louis, and Duquesne early in the 2016 calendar year. What's your thoughts overall on the A-10? Are you, along with Dayton and Rhode Island and Davidson, among the top four in the preseason poll? But what are your thoughts overall on the top teams in the Atlantic 10 this year?
Well, I think it's a strong conference. I think it'll be back to being a four or five bid conference this year. Last year, the league was a little bit young and inexperienced. Mm-hmm. There's some terrific coaches in our conference. So when you get in the conference games, anyone can beat anyone. And some of the teams that, you know, haven't done well in the past are much improved. You know, Duquesne and Fordham are much improved teams. And, you know, we play – it's an unbalanced schedule, which I don't like, but we have to play VCU, Davidson, and Richmond twice. And those are probably three of the best five or six teams in our league. But, you know, what I like is that getting bids to NCAA tournament is all based on, you know, RPI and all those statistical data. So, you know, you could see a team come in fifth or sixth place in our conference and still go to the NCAA tournament over a team that might come in second or third place. So we know the conference is going to be great. There's been some great wins. You know, our Virginia win, Dayton winning at Vanderbilt, who at the time was very one of the ranked teams and very strong team. Even a win like St. Joe's had at Temple the other day is great for our conference. So I'm cheering for all those guys, and hopefully we can continue to get some great non-conference wins.
Yeah. Before you get into the Atlantic 10 schedule, I just want to get your thoughts before we let you go. You have some more non-conference games coming up. DePaul, of course, coming up. You're going to be on the road a little bit around the holidays. How do you view working through the holiday season, and is there anything specific you'd really like to achieve in the games leading up to the start of your A-10 schedule?
Well, we want to try to win these last three games. They're not going to be easy. We're playing St. Peter's on Saturday. Coach Dunn does a great job with them. And, you know, they beat Siena earlier this year, and they've lost a couple close games. Then we have to play at DePaul. They had won four in a row before losing, you know, the other night. But Dave Leto's got them going again, and they're playing really hard. And, you know, at Central Florida right after Christmas, they beat UMass from our conference, who's a talented team. So none of the games are going to be easy. But we want to try to, you know, try to get those wins, and as we do prepare. So we want to get better as a team, better defensively. We want to continue to improve our outside shooting. And then really I want to keep developing our bench. In the last game, we were able to play extended minutes to Anthony Swan and a young freshman named Jordan Rowland, who had his best game for us. So we want to get to where we're confident playing 9, 10, or even 11 guys.
Coach Lonergan, thanks so much for your time and continued success to you and your program at George Washington.
Thanks for having me on, Chris. Happy holidays.
It was our pleasure. Thanks for joining us. Mike Lonergan, the outstanding head coach at George Washington University, the men's basketball program, off to another great season here during the 2015-2016 NCAA basketball season. We'd like to thank all of you for watching us and all of our guests on tonight's edition of RCN Sports Talk. Don't forget, we're going to be back next week with another live show starting at 7 p.m. For everyone at RCN, I'm Chris Michael. Good night.